1967. But what you might not know is that Cameron's movie closely follows another film about the Titanic that came out about 40 years prior, called A Night to Remember. In this video, we're going to be taking a look at the vast similarities between the two movies and point out where James Cameron got a lot of the inspiration for his. And first off, I have to say I'm a big fan of both movies. This video is not meant to attack Cameron's film in particular or criticize his work, because I mean, come on, this is the guy who gave us Terminator and Aliens, right? For those two films alone, he's always going to be a pretty cool guy in my book. This head-to-head comparison is simply to share an observation from an objective point of view and bring some interesting trivia to the fan base. Like so many others, I've always been fascinated by the story of the Titanic, and for this reason, I'm almost embarrassed to say that recently I finally sat down and watched A Night to Remember for the very first time ever. I have no idea how this movie avoided me for so long. But I watched it, and to those of you who have already seen it, I'm sure it comes as no surprise it immediately became one of my favorites. I found the presentation, acting, and accurate storytelling all very impressive. And I love the fact that they included the Californian and Captain Stanley Lord's long-debated role of the story into the film. A piece of history that several other well-known Titanic films chose to ignore. But we're not going to get into that argument here. For those of you who are familiar with the Californian controversy, you surely know that's a whole different topic for another day. But as I watched A Night to Remember, it didn't take long for me to start noticing direct similarities to Cameron's blockbuster. And keeping in mind, there's only so many ways a Titanic story can be told before certain elements of it overlap and run together. But in this case, what we're about to look at shows a great deal of direct similarity from not just the story, but from the production standpoint as well. In many ways, I can't help but feel like Cameron's classic, minus the Leo Winslet romance, is more of a remake of A Night to Remember. Not only are certain scenes from it closely recreated, but there's also a certain dialogue that's nearly identical between the two films. What you're about to see is a highlight reel showing a scene-by-scene comparison of the segments that Cameron's movie closely follows. Let's take a look.
Naturally, Captain, you'll use your own judgment. I'm just an ordinary passenger on this trip.
Of course, I'm just a passenger. I leave it to your good officers to decide what's best.
Six carats to be exact.
Here, what do you think you're up to? I'll have you arrested for damaging company's property. The lot of you.
Here. What do you think you're doing? You'll have to pay for that, you know. That's White Star Line property.
Shut up!
As far as I can see, she made 14 feet of water in the first 10 minutes after the collision.
Water 14 feet above the keel in 10 minutes.
It's a mathematical certainty.
It is a mathematical certainty.
Stewardess.
Yes, sir?
Why aren't you wearing your lifebelt?
Well, the passengers mustn't think I'm scared.
Let them see you wearing it. Put it on, child. For your own sake, too.
Yes, for God's sake, put on your lifebelt. Set a good example.
Mr. Andrews.
Yes?
I'd like you to tell me something. I have a wife and three children on board. Just how serious is it? I'm not the panicking kind.
The ship has about an hour to live. A little more, some of the upper bulkheads hold, but not much more. Get your wife and children into the boat.
Thank you.
Thank you.
between us. You have come to show you. Go on. Near, far, wherever you are, I believe that your heart does. Go on.
A gift, and I don't intend on wasting it. You never know what hand you're gonna get dealt next. You learn to take life as it comes at you.
When the ship docks,